All there, great people. Hope you are doing well. Greetings from Portugal. Thank you for stopping by. So many of you have requested, and since I have a video on, you know, iPad Air running iOS 12, how fast it is, you know, I've been neglecting these older devices. I've been, you know, with my iPhone 8, iPhone XS that I already, you know, given up. And you can see that on a video that I have, why I did it. But keep in mind, keep, you know, just a quick note, we'll have an iPhone X, you know, in not a long time here for the channel, you know, in order for you to show you also newer devices. But well, since you were asking on iOS 12, okay, I'm running on this device, iOS 12.1, beta 2, okay, guys, so just for you to check the build number, and you know already, but just for you to check, build number 16B5068i, okay, iPad Air first generation running this build. Now let's go ahead and put just aside, you know, because some of you like to see the Geekbench. I already made the Geekbench for this device. So this is the iPad Air first generation, known as the iPad 4.1, running iOS 12.1. It's the A7 chip from Apple and only 1 gig of RAM. So if I run here to the history, since I made the Geekbench yesterday, and you know, just for a quick laugh, as you can see, quite low, but this, you know, Geekbench is Geekbench. What we want to see is the real world usage. Keep in mind one thing, I use this device only for some media consumption, you know, taking this to the couch, seeing some YouTube videos, okay, you know, browsing the web, and not much more. But well, let's go ahead and open here some apps. For example, let's start with Safari. It was already open, you know, it takes a little bit to render. Have to tell you, it is a little bit slower than the final build, but not bad, okay, not bad. As you can see, we can't compare this to a newer device, but if you have this, you know, 5-year-old device running iOS 11, my suggestion is go ahead to the iOS 12. If you are running iOS 10 or 9, keep that, you know, stay on iOS 10 or iOS 9 on these older devices. But if you are on iOS 11, this will refresh, in fact, your device without any doubts. Okay, guys? So I'll be opening here some apps. Some of you tell me, hey, no, go ahead, open apps that are not web-based. But guys, I have to show you the apps that I use. You know, this is apps that I use on a regular basis, you know, web-based apps, YouTube, Safari. This is what I use this device for. But well, in order for you, you know, to keep everyone happy, I will try, and let me skip this ad. Thank you very much, Pixel Film Studios. This was my video regarding, you know, why I was returning the iPhone XS. You know, new videos will come on that. And as you can see, browsing YouTube, nice, no problems here. No, opening another one. Okay, this was on the iPhone 8, if you want to check. And of course, macOS Mojave. I'm also running, you know, Mojave and the beta builds of Mojave after the final build. Now, as you can see, for media consumption, everything seems to work pretty well. Let's open Twitch, why not? I'm not a big Twitch consumer, but well, I don't have here an account, but well, it takes this time to load. Let's go to Twitter, for example. Some apps are not yet optimized, but as you can see, guys, it opens quite well. Let's open the camera, for example. Let's see how much time it takes to, you know, already done, focus, picture, done. I'm not, well, I don't take pictures with this iPad. I'm trying to record, you know, in 60 frames for you to see, you know, drop frames and everything. And as you can see, these are all the apps that I have on the background. Now let's go to, for example, to let me see one of the apps that, let's go to Netflix, for example, why not? Let me see here, TV and movies, okay, TV and movies, let's open Netflix, see. Open it, perfect, no issues here. Let's invoke here the dock to make, you know, this device isn't able to make multitask, but let's open here, let's put the podcasts here aside and see how much time it takes, you know. It isn't, you know, quite optimized, but well, it is, in fact, if you want to put their mail, no problems whatsoever, you know, just a quick check, but I think it's quicker to go to the dock and it's quicker, you know, to quit the app and open the other one. Not, you know, this kind of multitasking on this iPad is not good at all. Now let's see here some stock apps, for example, from Apple. How much time it takes? A little bit, yeah. Good. Now let's open, for example, here not the web-based app. Let's go to Quick Note, for example. Let's see how much time it takes to load. Yeah, let's create here a new presentation. Perfect. Could be this one. If you use these devices, well, on work, on school, whatever. See, well, it is possible. Let's see if there is how much time it takes to. Okay. Yeah, it takes a little bit, some lag over here. Well, but then it works perfectly. Okay, quit. Good. And guys, this is what I want to show you. This device, you know, it's working properly for my use. Keep that in mind. And my suggestion, if I didn't said that already, is if you are running iOS 12, 11, sorry, go ahead and go to iOS 12 on these older devices. And since I have, my daughters have, for example, one iPhone 5S, one iPhone 6, and we saw a huge improvement when we installed iOS 12 on those devices. And on this iPad, I was running iOS 11. It was a nightmare, and I'm glad that this iPad, it's running, you know, pretty good for a five-year-old device on iOS 12. So I will keep, of course, these videos coming on older devices. Expect, of course, you know, updates and, you know, follow-ups on the iPhone 8. The iPhone 10 will be, you know, shortly here also on the channel. As you can see over here, the dock on my Apple Cinema display, I'm running macOS Mojave. So guys, for you that are new, if you want to see more content like this, go ahead. And there is a button over there. Thank you for stopping by, and I hope to see you on the next one. Stay safe. Bye-bye.